Okay. I think you all have went through with this case study, right? This is a textile, right? The fashion group of kind of a apparel company and operates in a highly competitive industry. To maintain its edge, right? Just go through with the case study, right? Then the company uses a variety of information systems to manage everything from day-to-day transaction to long-term strategic planning, right? Now we discussed several information systems. Then normally to manage operational level activities, we are using transaction processing systems. And apart from that, when it's come to the business intelligence systems, we had three: MIS, ESS, and ESS, right? All things we have discussed. Now here, the company operations are divided into different functional areas: order processing, inventory management, marketing, and executive decision making. Right now, you can see the areas or departments that they have. Each area uses a specific type of information system to achieve its goal. Right now, for each and every area, for each and every division, they have separate information system, right? And they are handling thousands of customer orders daily, right? And processing order entry, payment processing, all the things, and database, inventory database in real time, right? These kind of day-to-day transactions you can see here. And to keep up with the fast-paced fashion industry, this company's middle managers need to analyze sales trend. Now you can see the manager level, right? Managerial level you can see here. Sales trend, inventory levels, and marketing campaign performance. You can see here. And next point says about the marketing team at this company planning a major campaign for upcoming holiday season. They need to decide which product to promote, right? The scenario analysis is there. Next one, the executive team at this company meets quarterly review company performance and set long-term strategic goals. Strategic goals, how the top management using these information for their strategic decisions, what kind of system that they can use. And with that, you need to understand what type of information system is textile using to process customer orders and manage inventory updates in real time. What's your answer? Yes, what's your answer for the first one? Any guess? They're handling routine transactions, customer orders, inventory levels. Yes, anyone?
GPS.
Okay, any other answer? Yes, others, what do you think?
TPS.
Yes, exactly right. TPS, transaction processing systems. Because they clearly they have mentioned that what type of information systems is textile using to process customer orders and manage inventory updates in real time, right? Yes, you can see here. They are using the customer, they are using, they are handling thousands of customer orders daily across its e-commerce platforms and includes order entry, payment processing, updating inventory database in real time. Yeah. Now, you know, when it's come to the TPS, is the system that they are handling operational level activities, right? Therefore, yes, you can recommend that. The relevant information system is TPS, right? And the next part, explain its role in ensuring smooth daily operations. Now, then you can explain in your words how TPS ensuring the smooth daily operations, right? Daily operations. Yes. What's the answer for that? Yes. When you have a TPS system in your organization, how it enhances the efficiency of the operations, or how it smoothing the operations. Yes, any idea? At least in point wise. Yes, anyone?
Minimize manual data entry.
Okay, minimize the manual data entry. Okay. What else? Yes, when they are using TPS, they can smooth the daily operations in several ways. That's how you need to think. How you can enhance the efficiency of the operations by using TPS. Yes. Mainly in this question you have given, when through their TPS, they are handling customer orders as well as they are managing inventories well, right? From those two aspects, you can write down the methods that from these two aspects, right? How they are handling customer orders and how they are managing inventories. From those two aspects, you can write down the answer, right? How you can enhance the smoothness of the daily operation. Yes. First one. Yes. When you have this kind of system, yes, you can handle the customer orders. You can automate the customer order recording process, right? Then there will be no issue. There will not be any mistakes. Then you can satisfy your customers well, right? That's how you can handle the customer orders, because here the customer ordering receipt, that customer order process is very complex. Per day, they are receiving thousands of, in the case they have mentioned that per day they have they are receiving thousands of custom orders through their e-commerce platforms. At that time, when they are using TPS, they can automate all the orders, right? They can proceed those orders in real time without keeping them in a queue, right? That's how we can smooth the operations. Then operations going smoothly. And related to the inventory updates, yes. When we have a TPS, we can see the real inventory need, right? Just looking at the demand, we can determine the inventory level. Just looking at the production levels, right? Just looking at the production speed, we can determine the inventory level that we need. Yes, we know inventories are very important, because if we couldn't maintain proper inventory level, what will happen? As we discussed, if you don't have the sufficient inventory, you cannot produce. You can continue the manufacturing process, right? Then you have to stop the factory. Then it will stop the operations of the business, right? Then what will happen? Yes, you cannot cater to your customers. You cannot cater to your demand. Then again, in other side, if you couldn't satisfy your customers, they will leave you, right? Then you will lose your customer base. Then there will be a negative impact to your goodwill, right? The sales decrease, in the sense, expenses are constant, sales decrease. Then you can see the impact to the profit, right? There will be a negative impact to the profit as well. If you are facing these kind of issues regularly, definitely you have to close the business as well, right? So therefore, inventory is a key point, key factor that you need to consider. You have to manage inventory very carefully, because if you couldn't manage the inventory sufficiently, what will happen? Yes, operations will discontinue. You cannot run the business smoothly. You cannot run the production smoothly. Then definitely there will be problems, right? And if you maintain high levels of stock, what will happen? Your warehouses are full. Then you need to incur additional expenses, right, for the for maintaining such kind of inventories. You have to pay additional rents for the warehouses. There may be risk of damaging the inventories. There may be risk of expiry of the inventories, right? When you are maintaining high levels of stock, what will happen? Normally, there will be a risk of expiry, right? And they may be get expired. And there will be some damages from animals or some natural disaster, right? Then simply in accounting field, in accounting side, you can think that when you are maintaining high level of stock, in the sense you have invested your funds on the stocks unnecessarily, then liquidity issues may be there. Right? That's the impact to the organization. You don't have cash on hand to run the business because all the cash, the majority part of your cash, you have invested on inventories. Right? That's not a good practice. It may be an impact to your profit. It may be an impact to your smooth running of the business. And also the storage cost is high. That will increase the expense. It will increase the expense related to the storage cost, warehouse cost, rent, all the things. From all the aspects you have to think. Clear? Is it clear? Any question?
No.
Okay, the other question, how does the TPS help in reducing errors and improving efficiency in transaction processing tech stack? Right? How does the TPS help in reducing errors? Yes, automation is there, real-time visibility is there, real-time monitoring is there, right? Inventory level, you can monitor in real-time. Customer orders, you can automate it to proceed, right? That's how you can improve the efficiency. Third one. Which information system is responsible to generating routing reports? Routing reports. And how does it assist the middle level management in decision? Routing reports? What's the system?
MIS.
MIS. Yes. MIS. Very good. Then MIS assist him to make the middle level management decisions, right? They will provide, because here you can see the key point is for their decision making, they have clearly mentioned that they can determine the trend analysis, right? Middle manage to analyze the trends, inventory levels, and marketing campaign performance, right? When you have a management information system, you can manage them, you can analyze them, and you can take the successful decisions, right? You can take the insightful decisions here, meaningful decisions by having MIS. Describe how MIS could help take for this company respond to sudden increase in demand for a particular product. What is your answer? Yes? Yes, you can see here it has explained here. Where is that? Yeah. MIS, when you are using MIS, the middle managers need to analyze the sales trends, inventory levels, and marketing campaign performance. Such kind of things they can analyze. Right? What will happen in the seasonal period for our product? What would be the demand for our products? Right? In the new year season, during the Christmas season, what would be the demand for our products, right? They can determine sales analysis, sales trends, right? That's how they can use the MIS systems to support for their business activities, right? Then middle level managers, they can take decisions based on that. Then since they can be able to do the sales trend, they can identify increase in demand in the future, right? Then they can work today for the future demand. Then they can take decision for the future demand, right? That's how they can use the MIS. Final one, identify the information system that marketing team is using scenario analysis. right? How does the support their decision making process? Final one. Or not the final one. Fifth one, yes. Scenario analysis. What is the system? If we increase the price, what will happen to the our sales? If we decrease the price, what will happen to the profit of the organization? Likewise, they can do the some scenario analysis. What's the system? Anyone?
DSS.
Yes, exactly. DSS, decision support system. Before taking a decision, they can analyze scenario analysis. Please remember that one. Then in what ways can the DSS help the marketing team to optimize their holiday season campaign? Again, you can write down that answer. If they can use the DSS, how they can address that issue, right? Then they can forecast the future demand using the DSS, right? Now, through the MIS, you can identify the sales trends. Then to take the decision, you can use the DSS, decision support system, right? Now we have identified that in the future, you will have a huge demand. Then to address that demand, what you have to do, right? Then from the existing data, you can do some several scenario analysis. If we decrease the price or if we increase the price, if we purchase raw materials at lower cost, right? What will happen to our production? Then that how that affected the demand, right? Likewise, you can analyze everything. Anyway, please remember that scenario analysis or situation analysis you can do using DSS, right? DSS. Then again, for the last one, seventh one, which information system provides the executive team with the strategic insights? Top management. Yes, what is the system? That is easy, right? ESS, Executive Support System. Normally, they are taking strategic insight, not the routine task, not the routine decisions, right? The strategic decision, right? Long term, that means the strategic decisions is normally those decisions taken for the long term, right? Those decisions in long term, they are taking long term decisions, right, which will affect to the future of the business. Then that system is ESS, Executive Support System. Then they can analyze what are the opportunities in the market, what are the threats in the market, right? What are the resources within our business? What are the strengths of the business? What are the weaknesses of the business? All of these things they can analyze and they can take the strategic decisions. Clear? Then that is the thing you need to write down as the answer. Okay, now what you have to understand is we have mainly a transaction processing system and mainly we are dealing with operational level tasks and employees. And apart from that, we have three types of business intelligence systems. First one, MIS, ESS, and ESS, right? Then we discuss how those systems link with the management layers of the organization, as well as for what kind of situations, right? For such, what kind of situations we are using these systems, right? Yeah, information systems. That's all. Any question?
No.
Oh, okay. So I think most of you have an idea about the businesses, right? So that's why we had a separate subject earlier. We called operations management. Then you should have an idea about the operations. What will happen in a business? Business say ka kathole mona the venne kiya, right? Api dan meke dit katha karanne operations, the operations of the business. As we discussed, operate by when you are taking operations collectively, that is the business, In other way around, you can say the business consists of in several operations. Right? Business is consist of several operations. Then for each and every operation, you should have a proper idea, right? Yeah, at least basic idea. When you're going to implement a system, right? අපි ගිහිල්ලා system එකක් හදන්න යනකොට ඒකේ process එක අපි ඇත්තටම දැනගෙන ඉන්න ඕනේ. Procedures මොනවද? Manuals මොනවද? Right? කොහොමද මේ වැඩේ වෙන්නේ? ඒක තමයි මේ අපි මේ දේවල් ඉගෙන ගන්න. Then සහ management layers. දැන් අපි දන්නවා company එකේ ඉන්න management layers කිහිපයක් තියෙනවා. Top management එක ඉන්නවා, middle level ඉන්නවා, operational level managers ලා ඉන්නවා. Non-managerial employees, right? And you have to think from their aspect as well, what kind of decisions that they are taking and how those decisions link with the day-to-day operations, right? How those decisions link with the business decisions. Then with that, you can think about the information system, how those information systems assist to those management layers, right? That's how you need to think. Okay, that's all. If it's clear, yeah.
Sir, could you please upload those lecture materials before one day? I mean, we could get a printout if it's possible.
All right, sure. And I think we have another lecture on in this Wednesday also. I will upload those notes now.
Yes, sir, thank you.
Okay, sure. Good. Yes, yes, I think you all are clear with that, right? Isn't it? Any question? Or as if you are clear with that, let me know, because I think the chat option is again not there, right?
Yes, sir, clear.
Clear, okay. Others?
Clear, sir.
Okay. Okay, anyway, no worries. If you have any clarification, let me know, right? So even in Sinhala, you can ask. I know some students may not familiar with the English language that much. Even in Sinhala, you can ask, right? Sinhalengari ahanna or Sinhalengari explain karanna if you need. Right? Prashna thiyagena issarata yanne epa mokada eka aniwaryen ඒ කියන්නේ අපි මේ හැම පාඩමක්ම එකිනෙකට සම්බන්ධයි ළමයි. ඒක නිසා හැම වෙලෙම අයිඩියා තියාගෙන යන්න. ඊට අමතරව අනිවාර්යෙන් don't limit to the lecture materials, just read the recommended textbook as well, right? I will upload that one also, give me one or two days. I will take the soft copy, that is not yeah, sure. I will upload that textbook to the LMS, then you can read that relevant chapters and have an idea. There you can see additional case studies as well, and with the answers you can read them and have an idea, right? Exam එකදි මේ අතර මේ subject එකේ ලකුණු ගන්න ගොඩක් ලේසි, right? මොකද calculations එහෙම කුත් නෑ, as it is theory එක තමයි තියෙන්නේ. Application part එකෙන් ලියන්න තියෙන්නේ, right? Okay, with that we can wind up the session if you don't have any clarification. Okay, then we'll meet on this Wednesday, no? Yeah, I think we have another session on this Wednesday. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Ah, yeah, okay, because last Friday, Thursday. Yeah, last Wednesday we couldn't conduct the session. Then that's why we had rescheduled that session on this Monday. Then as usually, this week onwards, we can go, we can conduct the remaining sessions on Wednesday, right? Okay, then with that, let's wind up this session, and okay, good night.
Good night.